In this session, we select the ICF valve station. After this video, you will know how to select ICF via quick selection, how to make customized selection. You will also learn how to add chosen configuration to your favorites and how to generate the report. Let's start by selecting valves and line components and ICF valve station. Then let's look at a system type, and there we have pump separating system. Let's select the line where we want to put our ICF. The first thing we need to do is to specify the operating conditions. And for this example, we will put 300 kilowatt, minus 10, and plus 30. What the program then does is make quick selection of the six most commonly used configurations for the selected line. These configurations either can be delivered as DIN, EN, butt weld, or as ANSI socket weld connections. Let's look at the results. The first one needs a load capacity of 306.9%, meaning it's far too small. We go down and find that number 3 is the first option that seems to fit well. Let's select it. Simply double-click here to get the detailed picture of results. Here you can see type code of this configuration, and we see its type string, an ICF20-6-5, and it's a motorized valve with B66 code and this code number. Lots of data is available. The capacity, the load percentage. It's important to see that the ICM expansion valve has a load percentage of 39%. If we go down here, we will see it's actually open 60%. We can also data for the velocity for inlet, which is important. If it fits our requirements, we can choose this configuration with this type code. As you see, it was an easy selection. Customize modifications are also possible. How about testing a connection size modified to 25? As a result, velocity of the outlet increased to 21.56 meters per second. So probably it's a good idea to keep connection size of 32. When we customize, we also have a possibility to change the model. In this example, we will keep chosen configuration. If we want to save this configuration for the future projects, we can select Add to Favorites and can add a title. Every time we select this line, existing favorites will be displayed. This is a very easy way to select the valve, but there are also other ways to do it. We can select predefined ICF and instead of going to quick selection, choose search for ICF. And now we get the list of all configurations that can be used in this line. That's a bit complicated, but filters will narrow down the options. First thing we can do is to use the application code. In this case, code number 5 is actually liquid injection to separator, so all the configurations shown here have the configuration we need. Diagram that can be shown or hidden as we prefer. There are still too many options to choose from, so we need to narrow it down. We can apply filter on the housing, selecting ICF20. The model section we cannot change, because this is given by the application code. But we can change the connection. ANSI socket weld can be chosen with a size 32. Now we can see four options. Then if we look at KV value, we can see they are all different. This means we have different expansion valves. Let's select B66. And now we are down to one option. Double-click it to see the configuration in details. Detailed report can be generated with various elements like the total pressure drop of the valve or performance curve. This completes the session on selection of the ICF valve. Stay tuned for other tutorials on Coolselector.